the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today in the sight of God, these witnesses, family and friends, to witness the union of this man and this woman in holy matrimony. This is an honorable estate instituted and blessed by God in paradise. So I ask today, who gives this woman to be wedded in marital bliss?
My wife and I.
The union of husband and wife in heart, body, and mind is intended by God for the mutual companionship, help, and support that each person ought to receive from the other, both in prosperity and adversity. Marriage was also ordained so that man and woman may find delight in one another. Therefore, all persons who marry shall take a spouse in holiness and honor. For God has not called us to impurity, but in holiness. God also established marriage for the procreation of children, who are to be brought up in the fear and instruction of the Lord, so that they may offer him their praise. For these reasons, God established the holy estate that Jay and Jessica wish to enter. They desire our prayers as they begin their marriage in the Lord's name and with his blessing. Jay and Jessica, a reading from St. Paul, that love chapter from 1 Corinthians chapter 13. Love is patient. Love is kind. It is not jealous. It does not boast. And at the end, there is faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. There's a tower over in Italy in the town of Pisa. Anybody know what I'm talking about? Yeah, it slants one way, doesn't it, Jay? Yeah. But it's amazing, that tower, everybody knows what it is. And there's hundreds of towers in the town of Pisa. But there's just one that leans over. And we know that the original plans for this tower were that it goes straight. It wasn't intended to be tilted at all. But for whatever reasons, things didn't go according to plan. But what was created was something very beautiful and something very unique. So Jay and Jessica, I'm going to go out on a limb here and say that life to this point hasn't always gone exactly as you planned. There's been a few twists, a few turns, and sometimes the plans that you had weren't quite the way that you wanted, you envisioned them to be. But today you stand here, and just like that tower, we have something very special, something very unique, something very strong, bonded in love. And as you look out here today, I think you're going to see people that you're going to spend the rest of your life with. But as you look into each other's eyes, you see the person that you could not spend the rest of your life without. So Jay, I ask you, will you have this woman to be your wedded wife, to live together in the holy estate of matrimony as God ordained it? Will you nourish and cherish her as Christ loved his body, the church, giving himself up for her? Will you love, honor, and keep her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, remain united to her alone, so long as you both shall live? Then say, I will. Jessica, will you have this man to be your wedded husband, to live together in the holy estate of matrimony as God ordained it? Will you love, honor, and keep him in sickness and in health, and, forsaking all others, remain united to him alone, so long as you both shall live? Then say, I will. Jay, please repeat after me.
I, Jay, take you, Jessica.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy will.
According to God's holy will.
And I pledge to you my faithfulness.
I pledge to you my faithfulness.
Jessica. I, Jessica, take you, Jay. To be my wedded husband. To have and to hold from this day forward. For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. Till death do us part. According to God's holy will. And I pledge to you my faithfulness. We pray. Almighty Father, you have generously created all things to serve us for our good. Send your blessing upon this couple who shall wear these rings as a constant reminder of their marital fidelity. Grant that by your mercy that they may live gladly and faithfully in this holy estate, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Okay, repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
Wear it as a symbol of my endless love and commitment.
As a symbol of endless love.
With this ring, I thee wed. Wear it as a symbol of my endless love and commitment. And as those rings have that circle of no beginning and no end, so may your love for each other. Now that Jay and Jessica have committed themselves to each other in holy matrimony, have given themselves to each other in their solemn pledges, and have declared the same before God, these witnesses, and family and friends, it is my honor to pronounce them to be husband and wife, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Asunder. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. and Mrs. Jay and Jessica Baker. Yeah.